Let's take some time to bring forth compassion. Bring forth love for all living things. Bring forth compassion for all life, the life to the north and to the east. And to the south. And to the west. And above, and below. Offering compassion to all beings throughout the world, as to yourself. And consider this is the goal. This is the goal. This is what life is all about. To generate, abide in, and accept compassion for all beings. This is the goal. I'm doing it. I'm achieving the goal of life. And cultivate another state of mind. That what we do has an impact on these living things. Of course, it impacts us, it also impacts others. Consider that our actions have consequences, and those consequences are important. They matter. They change the world. And if we behave in certain ways, that will result in happiness and well-being, the ability to experience even more compassion. If we behave in other ways, that will result in harm, in suffering. And the tendency to experience ill will, separation, division, conflict. That we may behave in certain ways with our bodies. We may behave in certain ways with our words, our communication. We may behave in certain ways with our minds, with our thoughts or feelings. And all of that has consequences. If we behave in ways that are beneficial, that will lead to our happiness. If we behave in ways that are harmful, that will lead to our suffering. Cultivate this way of looking at things. Cultivate this empowerment of yourself. This acceptance of your power. An acceptance that you have and you're using that power all the time. With every thought and every word and every action, your power is being demonstrated and there are consequences. There's never a break. There's never a timeout. Why? Because you have that much power. And you always have that much power. And consider, if you're cultivating this state of mind, then you're doing it. You're achieving the purpose of life. You are on your way. This is it. It's not the entirety, but it's an essential aspect, and you are doing that right now. we've cultivated certain states of mind. And now we have the chance to relinquish certain states of mind. In particular, we relinquish attachment to self. And this is a good thing to do once we've cultivated compassion and an understanding of cause and effect. The easiest place to start with this is to simply look at your thoughts, listen to your thoughts, and any time that you notice one that's self-referential, bring your attention away from it to something available, such as your breath. Then you attend to your breath until you notice another self-referential thought. And then you bring your attention away from that and back to your breath. So there are many self-referential thoughts. I don't know how to do this is one of them. That's a self-referential thought. Well, bring your attention away from that and attend to your breath. I can't do this. That's a self-referential thought. So bring your attention away from that. Back to your breath. I am doing this. That's a self-referential thought. Bring your attention away from that and back to your breath. And just for today, in order to close this loop, close this circle, attempt to notice that when you're attending to this simple movement, the life in your breath, that you're happier than you are when you're thinking about yourself. Now, I want to be clear about this. There's a kind of happiness that comes from thinking about yourself, and there's a kind of happiness that comes from attending to the flow of your breath. I'm suggesting that the happiness that comes from attending to the living flow of your breath is better. It's more fulfilling. And if you're noticing that, well then, you're achieving the purpose of life. You're seeing directly how it is that attachment to self is suffering. And finally, notice that this living breath, an awareness of life in your body, rather than self-conscious thinking, that this awareness of life flowing through your body leads directly to compassion for all beings. That compassion leads directly to accepting virtue as a necessity of a meaningful life. which leads directly to setting aside that which causes such suffering, namely our attachment to self. When we set aside that attachment to self, then somehow this moment is already joyful, which leads directly to compassion, love for all beings. And so we move along in this loop, in this cycle, in this cultivation of mind.